Εδώ είμαστε. Καλησπέρα σας. Στα 13 λεπτάκια μετά από τις 5, είστε συντονισμένοι στο Libero 107,4. Ξεκινάει η εκπομπή All About Harrison Air.
Αυτή σήμερα, είναι η
Πέμπτη,
σίγουρα.
Στις 21 του Ιούνιου. Μια διαφορετική εκπομπή. Μια εκπομπή που σήμερα έχει την χαρά να φιλοξενεί έναν από τους πιο αγαπητούς ποδοσφαιριστές του Άρη, ο οποίος πριν 24 ώρες έβαλε την υπογραφή του στο νέο του συμβόλαιο διετούς διάρκειας και θα παραμείνει κάτοικος Κλεάνθης Βικελίδης μέχρι και το 2020. Τον αγαπάτε, σας αγαπάει και αυτός και τον έχουμε μαζί μας για να τα πούμε παρέα μέχρι και τις 7, τον Ούγκο Σόουζα. Ούγκο, welcome.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to me to be here.
You will speak in Greek for 2 hours.
Can you?
I think there is, that's no problem.
He's learning. Yeah, καταλαβαίνω λίγο. Σιγά σιγά.
Okay, we'll speak in Portuguese.
Better.
Nico, ξεκίνα στα πορτογαλικά.
Why? I don't know. Portuguese.
You are fired.
You
should learn Portuguese with Hugo. You should learn Spanish.
Yes.
Paco Herrera,
of course.
We will bring players. Argentina, Brazil, Uruguay. Παραγουάι, Εκουαδόρ. Okay, Ούγκο, first of all, welcome. And you know that you are one of the players that Aris fans love very much, and you end that in the 1.5 years that you are here in Greece.
Yes, it's true. I know that. I feel that. And this was one of the reasons that I stay again in Aris, you know, because these people respect me, they love me, and this was the most important thing to stay more 2 years in Aris.
Είπε ότι γνωρίζει την αγάπη του κόσμου, γι' αυτό και αποφάσισα να μείνω στην ομάδα, ένας σημαντικός λόγος για να μείνω. Με σέβονται, με αγαπάνε και το βλέπω αυτό. Είπε ο Ούγκο Σόουζα, how do you feel 24 hours after you signed your new contract? Because it was a lot of stress for you the last weeks.
Yes, it was very difficult situation for me, for my family, you know. It's not nice when you don't know if you stay in Greece, if you go out. No, it's not easy for us that we play football. And now that is everything finished, I'm really happy that continue in Aris.
Είμαι πολύ χαρούμενος που θα συνεχίσω στον Άρη, είπε ο Σόουζα. Θα πρέπει να φέρουμε φίλε ένα χαρτί και ένα στυλό όμως για να τα.
Να σου φέρουμε,
να σου φέρεις, φίλε.
Τι δουλειά κάνουμε εμείς εδώ.
Ναι. Λοιπόν, για να είμαστε και πιο ακριβείς, γιατί πήγαμε λίγο βιαστικά, Χρήστανθέ μου. How the negotiations with the president the last month, how was it? It was difficult. And I'm asking you this because even in your mind you weren't sure if you're gonna stay, if you're gonna leave. You wanted to stay, but everything was open in your mind the last month.
Yeah, President Karipidis know that first day that I want to stay in Aris because he know that I feel good in Salonik, I feel good in Aris. And from first day, President know that is my priority to stay, you know, in Aris. But of course it's not easy because, you know, we play football, we have short career and 32 years, 33, 34 finish the career. So I know we need to think about the future, you know. So was this the point that we negotiation? But President know that from the first day that I want to stay in Aris. This was my priority.
Ο Θόδωρος Καρυπίδης ήξερε από την πρώτη στιγμή ότι εγώ ήθελα να παραμείνω στην ομάδα. Το ήθελε και αυτός, αλλά στο ποδόσφαιρο παίζουν και άλλα πράγματα ρόλο. Είμαστε επαγγελματίες και κοιτάμε και άλλα πράγματα εμείς οι ποδοσφαιριστές. Αλλά από την αρχή είχα ως προτεραιότητα το να παραμείνω στον Άρη. Χρήστα, θες την επόμενη ερώτηση?
Μόλις μπήκα, ναι. I think that in the last month, on the last month, you were thinking a lot about your next contract. I was seeing that in your actions. I think you were a little bit nervous, more still good in your performances, but nervous. Was that true, or you know, many times we see something and say, "Ah, Ugo is playing like that because his contract ends," and it's not the true. The truth.
I understand what you say. No, I'm not agree about this because from the first game that I play, I give everything for Aris. When I play 90 minutes, I'm focused to take 3 points because I want to help Aris to go Super League, the place that this big team deserve. So all the games I was focused, you know, but okay, maybe you think this because it's normal. You know that my contract finished, I have offers to go. So I understand your point, but I give everything for Aris from the first game, you know, until today.
Από το πρώτο παιχνίδι της σεζόν μας λέει ότι έδινε το 100% για να βοηθήσει την ομάδα να πετύχει το στόχο της στην άνοδο στην Super League και απαντώντας στον κύριο Τσαλτίδη είπε ότι μπορεί να το βλέψεις έτσι διότι έλεγε το συμβόλαιό μου και αγώτησαν πολλά γενικότερα με το μέλλον μου. Δεν τον επηρέασε γενικότερα από τη, όλη αυτή η κατάσταση.
Was a point for you that Aris will have a Spanish coach, a coach that every Portugal player will understand better, I think, that from any other Greek or German or something like that. Your mentality, I think, is the same.
Yes, we have a very similar mentality. The language also is similar. I understand Spanish perfect, so it's good for me. I have one coach that I can speak fluently. Mm-hmm. And of course, this coach have a great CV. He's an experienced coach. He make a very good career. And of course, this was also was one point good to stay in Aris, you know, because I want to learn to coach, to be better, to improve every day, you know, to get better in my life, in my career.
Έχουμε παρόμοια φιλοσοφία με τον Ερέρα, λοιπόν, λέει ο Ούγκο Σόουζα. Μιλάμε και την πάνω κάτω την ίδια γλώσσα, μπορούμε να συνοηθούμε. Είναι καλό για μένα που ο Άρης θα έχει για προπονητή τον Πάκο Ερέρα, ο οποίος έχει και ένα πλούσιο βιογραφικό και μια μεγάλη καριέρα και θα με βοηθήσει και εμένα και όπως είπε χαρακτηριστικά ήταν και ένας από τους λόγους το ότι ο Άρης έφερε έναν έμπειρο προπονητή που αποφάσισε να παραμείνει τελικά στην ομάδα για τα επόμενα 2 χρόνια. Have you talked with him? Have you met?
No, not yet. Not yet. No.
I think nobody from the players. Still. Okay. You have about 15 days vacation.
Yes, to start. Yes.
10 days.
No, Ugo will stay from us. No, we don't have this power. did you know Paco Herrera from before? Okay, for a Greek, okay, we knew him from Liverpool.
Nah,
did you know from Portugal, from Spain?
I, to be honest to you, I call some person that know him, and everybody speak very positive about the coach. You know, they know the coach, and they speak he's good coach. He make, like I said before, he make good career.
His experience.
Experience, yes. You know, so I'm sure that he's good coach. You know, and I hope that he make a great job in Aris, because if he make a great job in Aris, it's good for all us.
Of course.
You know?
Μίλησα με άνθρωπο που τον γνώριζε και μου είπε πολύ καλά λόγια. Είναι ένας καλός προπονητής από αυτά που έχω μάθει και πιστεύω ότι θα βοηθήσει την ομάδα.
What about the players? Who will keep in Aris? Who will make new contracts? We decide, you know. Τζανακάκης, okay, is your friend, I understand. So Τζανακάκης will be in Aris for two more years.
He wants to make you technical director.
Don't say this because the people maybe believe that. You know. No.
Okay, they know that I'm joking. maybe we'll make Ilya.
No,
he is experienced.
Yes.
No, but won't be your manager if he comes to Aris. So no Ilya either.
If he comes, because you know Ilya, he likes Aris too much. He play. Mm-hmm. He told me that he play 1 year.
Yes.
And he told me from the first day that I arrived in Aris, he said that Aris is a very big team. They have a great fans and that I will like to play in Aris, you know. So everything that Ilya told me about Aris, today I can say that is true, you know.
And I think that he played a part in this deal with Aris.
Yeah, it was very important, you know. Ilya was very important for me to make the deal with Karipidis, to convince me also to stay. From, like I said to you before, from first day that I come Aris, he showed me how big is Aris, you know. From the first day he told me, Soze, okay, Aris now is a difficult moment, very difficult moment. He's in second division in Greece, but he still be a big team, you know, in the not in Greece, but in Europa, you know.
Για τον Ήλια Ήβιτς, Ούγκο είπε ότι του αρέσει πολύ ο Άρης. Μου είπε εξ αρχής όταν ήρθε στην Ελλάδα ότι πρόκειται μια μεγάλη ομάδα με σπουδαίο κόσμο. Η συμβολή του ήταν καταλυτική για να μείνω με όσα μου είπε το τελευταίο διάστημα και μου έδειξε πόσο μεγάλη είναι αυτή η ομάδα, εξηγώντας μου ότι ακόμα και τώρα που είχε κάποιες δύσκολες στιγμές παραμένει ένα μεγάλο μέγεθος και στην Ελλάδα αλλά και στην Ευρώπη.
I'll take you in the first moments in Aris. A Portugal player comes to Aris who has to play about 8 months. What were your thoughts for your new environment? And if somebody told you you have to play 8 months, why did you come here?
To be honest to you, if you want to speak, I don't have a problem to say about this, you know. Mm-hmm. When I come to Aris, it was the worst period in my life. I can say this today, you know. Because I get two injury in my feet, I stopped 8 months. Was very difficult period to me. Because I was in Belgium, in first division Belgium, I have very good contract, I play in very good team in Belgium. So, you know, the same time that I was in top of my career, I come to...
down.
To down, you know, too much down. And after, okay, Aris Ilya called me to speak about Aris. Aris in second division in Greece, you know, was difficult. I don't say to you that I don't lie to you. It was very hard to me to give step.
To help you. But you are a foreign player and you come in the second division. Mm. Everybody will think about that. We know what is Aris. You know what is Aris now. But I understand you perfectly.
And when I come, to be honest, okay, everybody says Aris is big team, but still in second division. And it's normal that the fans, they are not so together with the team, you know. They are angry to see his team in second division.
Yes.
So it was a difficult period for me and also for the fans from the team, you know. So when I come to Aris first day, I put in my head that I need to play top level to help this team to go up, and not only the team to go up. Also for me, in personality, for my career, I need to play good. Mm-hmm. Because if I don't play good now, if I don't help the team, it will be very difficult for me, you know.
You will stay in second division.
Exactly. So that's why if you speak about Sousa, everybody like me, because they know that from the first minute until the last minute, I give what I can do. I give my maximum focus and I give my life if I need to give my life, you know.
Mm-hmm. Λοιπόν, τον ρωτήσαμε για τον ερχομό του στον Άρη, το Γενάρη του 2017. Μας είπε χαρακτηριστικά ότι ήταν η χειρότερη στιγμή στην καριέρα του λόγω εκείνου του προβλήματος.
Όχι ότι ήρθε επειδή ήρθε στον Άρη.
Ναι,
λόγω του τραυματισμού.
Αυτό πήγαν από τώρα. Mm-hmm. Επειδή είχε εκείνο τον τραυματισμό που υπέστη όταν αγωνιζόταν στο Βέλγιο και στην Μπέβερνα, που όπως μας είπε ήταν μια δύσκολη περίοδο, είχε και ένα καλό συμβόλαιο στο Βέλγιο και ήμουνα εκείνη τη στιγμή στο top της καριέρας μου μέχρι εκείνο το σημείο. Ο Ήλια με κάλεσε και μου είπε για τον Άρη. Ήταν μια δύσκολη απόφαση για μένα λόγω της κατηγορίας που αγωνιζόταν η ομάδα. Όπως ήμουνα και εγώ σε μια δύσκολη περίοδο, αλλά ήθελα να βοηθήσω τον Άρη και μέσα από την πορεία της ομάδας να ωφεληθώ και εγώ, και παίζοντας καλά, και αυτό που είπε στο τέλος ότι όλοι με συμπαθούν γιατί ξέρουν ότι πάντα δίνω το 100% σε κάθε παιχνίδι. You came to the team last year and even though you haven't played for football for 7 months, we see you against Olympiacos showing very good picture in the field, and the 6 months that you played last year in the team. You
he is nervous too, because he's next to you.
The people loved you, and you loved the team in only 6 months.
Yeah, because like I said before, you know, I was very focused. I want to help the team. I want to help these people from Aris. Uh-huh. So I give everything, not only in the game, you know, because I believe this. I believe that for you play good, you need to training good. So it's what I make. I training every day. Every day I training good. I'm professional to go in the pitch at Sunday, at Saturday when we play, to be fit to play good, you know. So this is for me is the point. You need to train good to play good. And about this, you know, I think everybody know. Mm-hmm. That I'm very professional in this point, you know.
Να πω εγώ ότι όσοι θέλετε μπορείτε να στέλνετε μηνύματα FM και ενώ και αποστολή στο 54526 για να θέτετε κάποιες ερωτήσεις στον Ούγκο, είτε να τον ρωτήσετε κάτι, είτε να του επισημάνετε κάτι, είτε να του πείτε κάτι, και μετά, πιο μετά θα δούμε και πώς θα το πάμε ακριβώς στη συνέντευξη.
Τον ρωτήσαμε, ναι, βεβαίως. Τον ρωτήσαμε για το γεγονός ότι μέσα σε μόλις 6 μήνες και έδειξε πολύ καλά στοιχεία, ενώ είχε να αγωνιστεί 7 μήνες και πρόλαβε να αγαπήσει την ομάδα και να τον αγαπήσει και ο κόσμος. Και μας είπε ότι είναι επειδή έδωσα τα πάντα για να βοηθήσω και φαινόταν αυτό, δούλεψα σκληρά. Αυτό έχει σημασία, η προπόνηση και η σκληρή δουλειά. Ούγκο, in the end of the last season, we all expected that the team would promote to the Super League. That didn't happen. How do you feel? What were your thoughts? Because that's why you came.
Going back to Belgium.
To be honest, yes. Was
logical.
Why I can say to you, no. When you are professional, when you give everything, like I say, not only in the game, all the week that you train good, you play good, you make everything to get the target, to get your challenge. And after when finished season, I see that Aris don't get promoted. For me, personal, was very hard, you know, was very hard because I was sure that we're going to get the promotion, you know, and I work too much for this, you know, and after when I see that we don't get the target, was like, you know, I go also again down. I feel very bad and I just thinking to go out, you know, because I cannot play again in second division. I cannot, you know, because I feel very sad, you know, also for me and also for the people, you know. And okay, after I have meetings, we speak. I know that some teams ask for me in Greece, outside of Greece. I speak it present again. I speak it new coast, Spanos. Mm-hmm. I speak, I have 3 times Italia. And okay, all these people, they convince me to stay, to give one more opportunity to help again the team. But because next year we need to go Super League. And they show me again how big his are, you know. And after 1 week that I was thinking, I think, okay, I get the season to stay one more year, to be again professional, to be again focused, to put this big team in Aris, in Super League, you know. So I can say to you, this also was one point that I will never forget. I passed very difficult days in my life in Saloniki, in Aris, you know.
Θα ρωτήσαμε για το φινάλε της περσινής σεζόν που βρήκε τον Άρη να μην παίρνει τελικά την άνοδο και πώς το διαχειρίστηκε ο ίδιος. Για να είμαι ειλικρινής, είπε σχέθηκα να γυρίσω στο Βελγίο. Ήταν δύσκολο για μένα. Δούλεψα πολύ την περσινή χρονιά και ένιωθα άσχημα. Δεν ήθελα να παίξω ξανά στην Β' Εθνική. Κάποιες ομάδες και από την Ελλάδα και από το εξωτερικό εκδήλωσαν το ενδιαφέρον τους για μένα. Εγώ μίλησα και με τον Ήλια και με τον πρόεδρο και με τον προπονητή τον κύριο Σπανό και τον Παύλο Μηροφορίδη και με έπεισαν να μείνω. Μου έδειξαν πόσο μεγάλος είναι ο Άρης για μία ακόμη φορά και βάλαμε στόχο να επανέλθει η ομάδα τη νέα χρονιά στη Super League. Και προς το εγώ, όπως και έγινε.
No good.
What?
Something between us. Okay. Okay. Second division is history. Now you are in the first division with Aris. Everybody says that although we don't know who will be your teammates, everybody says, okay, you play in Aris. Minimum fifth place in Europe. How easy is this for a club from the second division to go up to Europe? Something to tell you. Aris is the third time that comes back from second division. The previous two times, he went from the second division to Europe. He earned the one place in Europe.
Look, about this is very important point, you know, and everybody need to think about that, you know. It's very important that we speak about this, you know. Mm-hmm. Inside of, okay, coach, when we start season, the training, sure that coach will speak about this. We're going to speak together at present because this is very important, you know, to make some target for our season. We play in big team, okay, Aris is top 5 in Greece, you know. It's a big team in Europa, like everybody knows. Of course, if we play in big team, we need to think like big. So we need to think to go maximum as possible. But at the same time, we need to go step by step. For me, this is very important, you know, to go game by game, to take 3 points game by game, you know. It's better go step by step than go, you want to pass 3-4 steps in front, and after you fall down, you understand me? So this, for me, is a very good question, and is one thing that everybody needs to think about that. So I want to say also to the fans, to come together in Carilau game by game and continue to support us like they make before in the that they was very important in football league, you know, to help us to get 3 points game by game. And if we don't get 3 points, I want to ask again to them to continue support, because step by step we're gonna get target, that we're gonna put Aris again the place that they deserve.
Λοιπόν, για το στόχο του Άρη τη νέα σεζόν είναι κάτι σημαντικό. Θα μιλήσουμε και με τον προπονητή τις πρώτες μέρες προετοιμασίας για τον στόχο που θα έχουμε. Ο Άρης είναι μια της top 5 ομάδες της Ελλάδος και με πορεία στην Ευρώπη. Από τη στιγμή που παίζουμε σε μια μεγάλη ομάδα, πρέπει να σκεφτόμαστε και ως μεγάλη ομάδα. Πρέπει όμως τα πάντα να τα κάνουμε βήμα-βήμα, παιχνίδι με παιχνίδι. Και αυτό που θέλω να ζητήσω από τον κόσμο είναι να έρχεται στο γήπεδο και να μας υποστηρίζει όλοι μαζί, παιχνίδι με παιχνίδι, να προχωρήσουμε την επόμενη σεζόν.
Θα κάνουμε και κάτι ακόμα. Είπε ότι είναι πάρα πολύ σημαντικό να είμαστε ρεαλιστές και να ξέρουμε το τι ακριβώς συμβαίνει. Το βήμα-βήμα και το παιχνίδι-παιχνίδι πρέπει να το αντιλαμβανόμαστε όντως, γιατί ο Άρης ναι μεν είναι μεγάλη ομάδα, αλλά και δεν θα πρέπει να γίνει εντός εισαγωγικών βίαια αυτή η άνοδος προς τα πάνω. Είναι σημαντικό αυτό για να το καταλαβαίνει ο καθένας από εμάς και εγώ χαίρομαι που το αντιλαμβάνονται οι ποδοσφαιριστές της ομάδας. Δηλαδή, από τη μία υπάρχει ο μεγάλος στόχος, γιατί μιλάμε για τον Άρη, αλλά από την άλλη αυτό πρέπει να γίνει σταδιακά. Αυτή η αλλαγή και η μετάλλαξη να γίνει σταδιακά.
Να κάνουμε ένα διάλειμμα, επειδή έχουμε φτάσει 5.30.
Πάμε, ναι. Απλά να πω, we will give for the last year. We will give extra prim to Neto, because he kept you here or no? He deserves, I think, 5-10,000. I will call Theo to tell him how much money we should give to Neto, as Aris, not you, as Aris, that I think he was one of the people that Souza think, okay, Neto is my friend. Neto tells me to stay. He should be right.
To be honest to you, you know why it's funny between me and Neto. The first day I come to Aris, Neto speak Brazilian. Portuguese are the mm-hmm. same language.
Yeah, Portuguese.
Know? Yes. And when I start to go out, it's Neto. I see Neto every time, take photographia, selfie, pectara, Neto, nectaro,
truta.
And you know, I go in Salonika, say, wow, Neto, why this guy, Aris is very big. You know? Yeah. Everybody know Neto, everybody. Okay, one day I will be like this, you know, I will play good because I want also to feel like this. And Neto say, yes, you see how I do? You make the same and you're going to be the same, you know. So it was very funny because all the situation, after some months, I start to be also not like Neto, not yet, but, you know, the people start to like me.
You know, Neto lost 400,000 euros. Don't be like him. Okay, he got a lot of money from Aris. He says that. But Neto is one of the best guys from one other country that came.
Very good character.
Loved Aris. Yeah. Yes. And because fans know what Neto gave to Aris, that's why everybody respects him.
Yes, it's true.
And I hope that you, Hugo, after 4, 5, 6 years, if you will be here, that means that you will be like Neto. You will earn money for your family, and this is your job.
It's my target.
Everybody must think, okay, we love Aris, but Hugo and everybody other is professional. He lives from that. So Aris must pay him. But if you are here, I hope that you will be like Neto. And another Hugo Souza, younger, will be next to you.
I hope that put Aris again in Super League, in the
Europa League.
Europa League, you know, to pass great things like Neto pass, to go Atletico Madrid, Manchester City. Mm-hmm. You know, this is the target from, I think, every player. All the players, they want to play Europa League, you know. So when I see Neto get this target, of course, I try to follow him. Or maybe make better than Neto, you know, mm-hmm. because I believe that if
better
we work...
Better than Neto, no.
I believe, why not?
Neto is the best. He's my friend. Okay, translate.
Λοιπόν, να πω αυτό που είπε για τον Neto στο ξεκίνημα και να πάμε στο διάλειμμα. Την πρώτη μέρα που ήρθα, είδα τον Neto να μιλάει πορτογαλικά και έτσι αναγνώρισα τη γλώσσα. Έβλεπα που έβγαινε ο κόσμος φωτογραφίες μαζί του και όλοι μιλούσαν για τον Neto και αντιλήφθηκα πόσο μεγάλο μέγεθος είναι ο Neto για τον Άρη. Και αυτό που μου είπε ο ίδιος ο Neto είναι ότι κάποια μέρα. Αν μείνεις εδώ και συνεχίσεις έτσι, θα γίνεις και εσύ σαν και εμένα. Θα ζεις και εσύ αυτή την κατάσταση. Λοιπόν, να πάμε σε ένα διάλειμμα, Χρήστο και Όση, και θα επιστρέψουμε με ακόμα περισσότερο Hugo Souza εδώ στο Libero 107,4. Εδώ είμαστε, επιστρέψαμε στα 47 λεπτά και μετά από τις.
Ας να πούμε για τις μπριζόλες.
5. Μιλάνε εδώ πέρα ο Χρήστος με τον Hugo για τις μπριζόλες. You like steaks?
I like, of course.
The best are Argentinians, eh?
Argentina, yeah. Yes. Top. Brazil also very good picanha. Picanha.
Picanha.
Yes.
Picanha.
Yeah, you know Moscarisia. Moscarisia.
In Greece also very good food. I like too much food, Greece.
Yeah, but gyros, but
Γύρω στο βλάκια, no.
No good.
No healthy.
Okay. One fan says, τις αλλαγές στο κήπεδο και στο Ρίσιο, πώς τις βλέπει. How do you see all the changes in Ρίσιο and Vikelidis? I think it's very important for a player.
Of course it is, you know, it's very important to go center training and you see good center training, you know. It gives you extra motivation to train more, you know. I believe it's very important. Present explain me a little about what you want to do in the Rysiu, in Carilau. I understand the project that present have. Mm-hmm. So I believe that will be very good, you know, for the Aris, for the players to work more, to be more professional. It's very good step.
Είναι σημαντικό, μας είπε, το ρωτήσαμε για τις ερώτηση του φίλου βασικά για τις εργασίες στο Ρίσιο και στο Βικελίδης. Είναι σημαντικό να γίνονται αυτά τα πράγματα. Μου μίλησε και ο Θόδωρος Καρυπίδης για τη σκέψη του και για αυτά τα οποία θέλει να κάνει στις εγκαταστάσεις της ομάδας. Και είναι πολύ σημαντικό να, για τους παίχτες να δουλεύουν επαγγελματικά μέσα σε επαγγελματικές συνθήκες. Many of your, some of your teammates, when, during the year, they told us about some difficulties you had during the season.
He always asks about the difficulties. It's his favorite point.
It's important. Without going into details.
He has no difficulties. He stays.
My teammates, they say that I have some problems.
No, you, the team.
The team.
Okay. The whole team. Okay,
you struggle.
Some delays. This is what he means.
Not
some
delays. Όχι αυτό ακριβώς. What I want to say is that
despite say it in Greek and we will translate.
Despite the struggles you had, you made your point and you achieved your goal and the team got promoted. And I think something very important was that you were like a family during this season.
He saved it.
You know, everybody knows, you know, that we have difficult moments, you know, like players, like team, like for everybody. Of course, when you are football league, it's not easy, you know, for the team, for, of course, it's difficult for the present, for everybody is difficult, you know. Uh-huh. So, of course, I don't say that we don't have problems. Yes, we have problems. But every time we try to take care about the problems together, like a team, you know, to go in the pitch and to take 3 points, because the most important is to always go to Super League. Understand me? Mm-hmm. So okay, we have problems, but we passed these problems, and now it's passed. You know, no, it's not important anymore. Okay, it's true that we have problems, but it's fixed now.
Το ρωτήσαμε για κάποιες σχολίες για τις οποίες έκαναν λόγο κάποιοι παίκτες του Άρη μέσα στην σεζόν. Φυσιολογικές βέβαια, εντάξει. Το παραδέχτηκε ο ίδιος. Είχαμε κάποιες δύσκολες στιγμές. Είναι γενικότερα ήταν μια δύσκολη κατηγορία για όλους μας, για τους παίκτες, για τον προπονητή, για τον πρόεδρο. Τα αντιμετωπίσαμε όμως όλοι μαζί, ενωμένοι, σε μια γροθιά, με στόχο την άνοδο. Και τα ξεπεράσαμε. Δεν θα, όπως είπε στο τέλος, τα έχουμε αφήσει στο παρελθόν και δεν θα υπάρχουν την νέα σεζόν αυτά τα ζητήματα.
Another fan says that Velizis probably stays in the club. We'll see it in the next days. It is something that it's good for you because he says that the last year you were the best two defenders in second division. Of course, you know too.
And
it's something else, football league, something else, Super League, and probably good players will come for defense too. This is the program of the coach.
And I want to add something.
Maybe they will speak your language, yes. The other player.
And I want to add something that Mr. Spano said when he was here, that the team of the next season must start from you and Deli.
I don't know if Deli stay or no. This is point of present and the new coach, you know. Mm-hmm. About Deli, he come to Aris. Some people, they say he's a good player. Some people, they say he's not a good player. And when we start to play together, we make a good combination, you know. I think he make a good season. He play good, so if present think, I'm agree to Deli stay one more year, you know. Now mm-hmm. about next year, you know, now it's totally different, you know. We are in Super League. We have a new coach. It's different mentality, different, you know how is football. So now we start pre-season. We need to work to show the new coach that we are good players. And who coach decide to play, we need to respect and continue work to play, you know. So, okay, it's a good point to Del Este or Maragos, I don't know, whatever they want to take. The important is that is make a good team, strong team, to go to fight for the 3 points every game, you know.
Δεν ξέρω για τον Δελιζήση αν θα μείνει. Ταιριάξαμε την... τι λέτε, παιδιά?
Ναι, λέγεσαι.
Ταιριάξαμε πάντως την φετινή σεζόν. Εντάξει, τώρα τη νέα χρονιά θα παίξουμε στην Super League με ένα προπονητή που έχει μια νέα φιλοσοφία και θα σεβαστούμε φυσικά τις επιλογές που θα κάνει. Σημασία έχει η ομάδα να παρουσιαστεί δυνατή και να πετύχει τους στόχους της.
Many times, whenever we speak with the president, we say about organization, about how we will make the fields and all these things. I think that you, the players, speak about all this, and you expect more things in the next year from in this part of the game. Part of the game.
Of course, it's part. If you are in the big team, we need to have also good things, you know, inside of the team, you know. So president know this, like I say, and everybody knows that president try to make a new center training, make some change. He want to make some change in Carilau. Mm-hmm. So of course we players we want this, and we are very happy for these things happen, you know.
Για τις συνθήκες της ομάδας όσον αφορά την νέα σεζόν, είμαστε μια μεγάλη ομάδα όπως είναι ο Άρης και είναι φυσιολογικό να θέλουμε καλές συνθήκες. Ο πρόεδρος κάνει αλλαγές και στο Ρήσιο και στο Βικελίδης και είναι καλό να γίνονται αυτά τα πράγματα για την ομάδα.
Okay, see, about 2 months ago after the game in Καλυθέα, the 3 goals, I wrote to Mr. Pereira, he is Portuguese, you know. Mm-hmm. The first one in... in referees in Greece is Portuguese. Oh, okay. So you should call him. I don't know, it's my spelling, okay?
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
How we spell this? To be Senhor Pereira?
Você está vendo os orgias contra o Ares. You know, and this is true, you know. The first day I come in Ares, I see the Ares have a lot of problems with a lot of people. I don't know why, you know. Mm-hmm. Because maybe Ares is too big. That's why sometimes I see strange things against Ares, you know. Mm-hmm. Even the teams, every time they play against Aris, they want to give everything, you know, they want to make down Aris. I don't know why, but at the same time I know Aris is big team and they don't want to see Aris again help. But the important is that Aris is again help, you know, this is very important.
Mm-hmm. Το ρωτήσαμε σχετικά με το κομμάτι της διαιτησίας και είπε ότι από την πρώτη μέρα που ήρθατε πίσω ότι κάποιες φορές γίνονταν κάποια περίεργα πράγματα εις βάρος της ομάδας ή βλέπαμε ομάδες που...
Google Translate.
Τι?
Όχι, ναι, προχώρα.
Ναι, ή βλέπαμε ομάδες οι οποίες έδειχναν έτσι ένα υπερβάλλοντα ζήλο απέναντι μας. Το σημαντικό όμως είναι ότι εμείς πετύχαμε το στόχο μας και ανεβήκαμε στην πρώτη εθνική.
Όπως λες, Παπαδόπουλε, μπορώ να γράφω και Πορτσουγκίζες εδώ πέρα.
Μάλιστα.
Το καταλαβαίνεις όλα αυτά.
Μάλιστα.
Οπότε τα είπαμε σωστά. Okay, we have Senor Pereira and 2 Spanish who decide for the referees. So Paco Herrera and Tungo Sosa will call them, and we have 4 penalties each game. I don't think so, but okay.
I don't think so.
You were in Belgium. You were in Cyprus. You were, of course, in Portugal. First of all, do you know that Aris has played in history with Eusebio, and we put Eusebio out against Benfica? About 40 years ago.
You know why I know? The first day that I go and sign my contract, I see one shirt in the Carilau from Sporting. And mm-hmm. I ask and they told me, you know, about this. I know that.
It's one of the biggest moments in history because Aris won here 3-1 and went to Benfica, was losing until 80 minute 2-0 and scored 1 goal and... After they played with Perugia, I think, 1979, I was 2 years old.
I wasn't even born.
No, but I know the story. I know the story because I ask why this shirt is here, and mm-hmm. they say Portugal, Greece, and they explained me about this, you know, about these points mm-hmm. in Aris
okay.
long time ago.
The biggest moment, of course, is against Atletico Madrid. Yeah. Aris is the only Greek team that has a win in Spain. No one else, Olympiacos, Panathinaikos, AEK, PAOK, nobody has a win in Spain. And this is the dream of the Irish fans, to live again this kind of things.
I know that, you know, sometimes I go to cafe, to restaurant, mm-hmm. and people, they come next to me to show me videos in YouTube, you know. Mm-hmm. this moment is historic in his life, you know. It's great to see the fans and artists to remember these things, you know. And believe me, everybody asked me, Sosa, please, well, let's go again. We want Europa League. We want again to big things, you know. We are tired of the situation, you know. So I know all the what they pass, what they expect. And okay, we're going to work every day to these things will come back to Aris, you know.
Mm-hmm. Μας είπε, ανοίξαμε την κουβέντα και για τη, πιο παλιά με την Μπενφίκα και πρόσφατα με την Αθλέτικο. Κάποιες φορές θα είμαι έξω για καφέ, για φαγητό και το φίλοι του Άρη και μου δείχνουν κάποια βίντεο. Είναι σημαντικό αυτό, να θυμούνται αυτές οι επιτυχίες της ομάδας. Θέλουν και αυτοί και μου το ζητάνε να τις ζήσουμε ξανά. Εμείς αυτό το οποίο θα κάνουμε είναι θα δουλέψουμε σκληρά προκειμένου να ζήσει ο Άρης ανάλογες στιγμές όπως αυτές με την Αθλέτικο Μαδρίτης πριν από λίγα χρόνια. Το ρύθμι στο χρηματιστικό Χρυσανθέμου. Πάρα πολύ ωραία. Επόμενη ερώτηση για Τζαλντίδη.
Εγώ τις κάνω όλες.
Ναι, ναι, ναι. Μια χαρά πάμε.
We pay him, I ask always. Why?
I do the translation.
Okay.
Okay.
We need a translator for Eco Paco Herrera.
I will go.
Okay. I hope in the Sunday I speak Greek, you know. I start to have some teacher to help me.
Ah, you speak?
Yes,
a little bit.
I have lessons, I have lessons. And I hope that I learn quickly the Greek.
You, when you go out, you speak Greek or English?
No, I English. Speak in English, yes. But siga siga, εγώ κάτι μιλά λίγο, λίγο.
Poco, poco. Poco, poco. Do you watch the games, World Cup?
Of course, I follow Portugal, my friend. I hope Portugal get again Mundial. You,
you got very excited with Ronaldo against Spain.
Of course, you know. You know,
he's
Ronaldo,
a good player.
No, Ronaldo for us is God, you know, because yeah. I explain you why. We speak about Brazil, Argentina, but Portugal is a very small country. You mm-hmm. understand me? Portugal is a small country. And if you see, we have the best coach in the world, José Mourinho. And we have the best player in the world is Cristiano Ronaldo. Sorry, this is my opinion. So every Portuguese,
I will tell you. Wait, can't be the best coach a coach of Manchester United. No,
he's a Liverpool fan. I'm a United fan.
Remember, Paco Herrera was in Liverpool. Remember, Hugo.
He made a mistake sometime in his career.
Μας λέει ότι έχουν τον καλύτερο προπονητή στον κόσμο, που είναι ο Μουρίνιο. Και τον καλύτερο παίκτη ναι. στον κόσμο και που είναι ο Ρονάλντο.
Τον οποίο είπε ότι σε μια μικρή χώρα όπως η Πορτογαλία τον έχουμε σαν θεό. Ναι.
I think that he plays like a god. sometimes can be possible a player to do all these things. Yesterday everybody said, oh, what a goal he scored or against Spain. I didn't see that. I saw how high he jumped after the goal.
Yeah.
And I say, yes. A basketball player can do this. Only Michael Jordan. This is why Ronaldo, although some guys say, oh, okay, he's too God.
He's too arrogant.
But yes. You know something, in Portugal, everybody respects Ronaldo and we are proud from Ronaldo. And for me, his example is like an idol for me. You know mm-hmm. why? Because he don't have maybe the technique that Messi have, mm-hmm. but he work too much. I have friends, they play national team together with Cristiano. I know a lot of things about Cristiano. Mm-hmm. And the way that he work, the way that he fight for his life, to help his family, to get the things that he get.
It's important.
It's very important for me. This is football professional player. And mm-hmm. this for me is example, you know. When I see Ronaldo, I see one person that he don't have nothing in life. His family is very poor. He don't have money to buy something, t-shirt, nothing. Mm-hmm. And now we see he's one of the person more rich in the world. Mm-hmm. Nobody give nothing for Ronaldo. He fight for all these things. You understand, man?
Yeah,
in Portugal, we are very poor country. Mm-hmm. We are a small country. You understand me?
Yes, of course.
And everybody respect Ronaldo because Ronaldo now is Ronaldo, the best player in the world. He's one of the person more rich in the world. And he make this alone. You know, so that's why we have a lot of proud from Cristiano Ronaldo. Mm-hmm.
Για τον Ρονάλντο μας είπε ότι τον σέβομαι απεριόριστα, είναι ένα είδωλο για μένα. Μπορεί να μην έχει λέει, την τεχνική του Μέση, αλλά δούλεψε πάρα πολύ στη ζωή του για να αποκτήσει όλα αυτά που έχει και αυτός και η οικογένειά του. Προερχόταν από μια φτωχή οικογένεια, δεν είχε τίποτα και τώρα είναι ένα από τους πιο πλούσιους ανθρώπους στον κόσμο, σε μια φτωχή και μικρή χώρα όπως η Πορτογαλία. Εμείς τον σεβόμαστε πολύ για όλα όσα έχει καταφέρει.
How did you feel when Greece got the Euro Cup? We were happy.
Wait, Greece play tomorrow, no? When play Greece?
Αρχίσαμε. Όχι, Manchester United. With Greece.
Okay, we'll go.
No, I joke, you know.
Okay.
I like to, I respect.
Don't set the contract.
I respect too much Greece, you know. I feel like home, and Greece in this moment is my second country, you know. Okay, it was very difficult when Greece beat Portugal, because Portugal is better, of course.
Two times, you lost in your house.
You score it corner, you know, everybody, Fernando Santos, defensive. Yeah. And after you wait for the corner, for free kick, and you score.
You know, but that okay. Fernando Santos was in PAOK, eh?
I know.
You know that?
I know, of course.
You
he lost in Aris, 2-0. 3-2 in Aris, always lost Fernando. Okay.
You are here 1 year and a half. You come from a poor country. The economic crisis that we'll talk about? Do you feel it? Do you see it in?
The football players see the economical crisis? I think.
Of course, because also we have problems, you know. Mm-hmm. So we feel also.
Yeah. Okay. It's problems, but the money that you earn are more
okay
than somebody who works for 500 euros per month.
But you know, in Greece, your mentality, you know, even if you don't have too much money, you enjoy the life.
What I want to say to,
if you don't have money, you go to coffee. If you don't have money, you go to drink something. So when I go to street, I see all streets full, so I don't see the crisis.
Yeah, because all the money go there.
Okay. So this is big. I know now,
you are right.
Today I understand your culture, you know. If you have 5 euros, no problem. You go to cafe and you spend 5 euros, you understand me?
Yes.
And before I was in Belgium, and in Belgium is another mentality, you know. Mm-hmm. The Belgian people, they work, they go home. Home, work, home. They don't enjoy the life, but it's true they have much money.
Mm-hmm.
Understand, but the mentality in Belgium is so different than in Greece. But I know that Greece have problems, but same time I don't see these problems, because I see everywhere full of people, every people is happy, everybody speak like nothing happened. So this but this is Greece.
I will send you my my bills. But it's exactly what you say.
You are agreed to me?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
Because this is the mentality of the Greek people.
Now I understand that, because it's 1 year and a half.
And the Portuguese are near Greece, yes, or Belgium?
No. We are in the middle.
In the middle?
In the middle. For me, Greece is the top, mm-hmm, after Portugal in the middle, and down is Belgium.
Mm-hmm.
About life, mm-hmm, style of life.
Τον ρωτήσαμε για την οικονομική κρίση και πώς την βλέπει ο ίδιος ως ποδοσφαιριστής στην Ελλάδα το τελευταίο 1,5 χρόνο. Είπε ότι στην Ελλάδα έχετε μια φιλοσοφία που, ακόμα και αν δεν έχετε λεφτά, απολαμβάνετε τη ζωή. Εγώ δεν βλέπω δηλαδή κάποια κρίση, και 5 ευρώ να έχετε, λέει, στην τσέπη σας, θα πάτε να πιείτε ένα καφέ και θα ξοδέψετε αυτά τα 5 ευρώ. Στο Βέλγιο, όπου έπαιξε, είναι πολύ διαφορετικά. Δουλεύουν και πάνε σπίτι. Δεν ζουν δηλαδή όπως στην Ελλάδα. Υπάρχει μια διαφορετική φιλοσοφία εδώ πέρα.
Mm-hmm.
Υπάρχουν προβλήματα, αλλά δεν το βλέπω. Εγώ δεν τη είναι η καθημερινότητά του. The lifestyle of Greece was a reason for you to stay here another 2 years.
No, my friend. No. Some people, they say, where you go, Sosa? Sosa, where you go, stay, Salonika, Aris? I say, not about this, you know, because we are football player. I'm professional player, you
He's
know.
He's not a singer.
I'm not a singer. My family need me. I have a lot of people that depends of me, you know. I need to see my life also, you know. Okay, I'm agree to you that Salonika is amazing city for me. I tell you again, I feel very good in Greece. I like the people in Greece. They are very friendly. But I'm a professional football player, you know. I need to see the best for me. I cannot stay because it's good city, you know. I can't stay because it's good team to play and it's good condition to stay, you know. Mm. Not about life, okay? It's good if you have good life in good team, of course it's good. But most important for me, because I'm professional, is my job, and my job is football. It's not the life, cafe, restaurant, you know.
Το ρωτήσαμε αν η ζωή στην Ελλάδα έπαιξε κάποιο ρόλο στο να αποφασίσει να παραμείνει εδώ πέρα. Είπε ότι πρώτα είμαι επαγγελματίας, εγώ θέλω να παίζω ποδόσφαιρο, είμαι ποδοσφαιριστής και να στηρίζω την οικογένειά μου. Δεν έμεινα στην Ελλάδα για τον καφέ, για να βγαίνω έξω κτλ. Έμεινα στην Ελλάδα για το ποδόσφαιρο και για τις συνθήκες που υπάρχουν αυτή τη στιγμή στην ομάδα μου.
Ο επαγγελματίας είναι αυτό που λέει ο Ούγκο. Ο επαγγελματίας ποδοσφαιριστής πρέπει να επιλέγει μία ομάδα για να ζήσει την οικογένειά του και να εργάζεται γι' αυτό, και όχι για να μένει σε μια ωραία πόλη όπως η Θεσσαλονίκη. Γιατί υπάρχει μια αίσθηση στον κόσμο. Α, έμεινε στη Θεσσαλονίκη. Α, είναι η Χαλκιδική δίπλα ή οτιδήποτε άλλο. Εγώ λέω ότι, okay, αν ήταν τραγουδιστής ή οτιδήποτε άλλο, ναι, μπορεί να τον απασχολούσαν τέτοιου ζητήματα. Αλλά αν ο επαγγελματίας ποδοσφαιριστής επιλέξει μια ομάδα ανάλογα με το σε ποια πόλη είναι. Okay. Then everybody will go to Las Vegas to play football.
Exactly.
It's the best.
Exactly.
Okay.
But you like Halkidiki?
No, I like Thessaloniki. I like too much, you know.
Okay,
like,
the environment is important. It's important. Environment. If you go to, that's why in Russia they give so much money. They say, okay, I will give you much money to come to a city that in 4 o'clock will be dark.
Nobody's outside. Yeah.
Okay, but. It's not the first thing, I think. Exactly. It's to be happy to play good football and be professional. I think the next question is that I understand, it's not exactly a question, it's something that I realize by meeting you, that the first thing in your career to be what you are now and to be better is that you are professional. And this is something that, you know, for foreign people in a very good environment like Thessaloniki is not easy. And I think that the fans see that to Souza. They see that you are professional. And I think when you are professional in the circumstances in second division, then will be easier for you in the first division.
And you were one of the few players that stayed in Rishu after training and you trained yourself alone.
Okay, this is you, he is your friend. That's why you said that.
No, it's true. It's true. Yeah. I like to make my training gym every time. Finish training, I stay more 1 hour. It's Neto because Neto also trained too much in gym. You know, I believe that you must to give everything. You know, to be a good player, first you need to prepare. You need to training. So it's true. I'm agree to you. I'm very professional. I give my maximum every day to improve. You know, because I believe that you need to be ready. When starts the game, you need to be 100%. You need to be better than the appointment, you know. Mm-hmm. To play better than striker, you need to be more physical, more better, you know, to play, to win all the balls, you know. So that's why I train too much, you know. And okay, it's true that Thessaloniki is a beautiful city. You have a lot of place to go, a lot of people. But, you know, you need to know the right moments that you can go out, you can go to drink something, you know. You have time for everything. You understand?
You should have time for enjoying your life too. Okay, but a professional player can go until 34, 35, less times than me.
Of course.
And everybody. Because I think, Hugo, it's respect to the fans.
Respect.
The fans see you. Okay, when you win, nobody will tell you anything. It's not good to tell you when you lose, but they know that you are a professional football player. You 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, I don't know what time, you should go back home. And this is one of the things that we must say about you, that never somebody tells us, hey, it's Friday and Hugo Souza is out. This is good. And please keep it.
No, of course, it's my, you know, it's my, I said to you, I come from youth, from me, you know. Like I said to you, you need to know your body. You need to know the right moments to go and when you can go and when you cannot go. Mm-hmm. This is very important for a football player because there is this big team. Wherever you go, if the people like you, everybody know that you are there. So I'm agree to you. You need to take care about your picture. You know, it's a picture about you. Mm-hmm. So I try to be example about this point. When I can go because I'm alone, of course I go. But when I cannot go, I need to stay home. Even if it's difficult, stay home alone, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's respect to yourself and the fans and the club.
Exactly.
Τον ρωτήσαμε γενικότερα για τον τρόπο που δουλεύει και για το γεγονός ότι είναι αρκετά επαγγελματίας και αυτό που το ρώτησα εγώ συγκεκριμένα ότι φέτος έμενε τουλάχιστον μια ώρα παραπάνω αρκετές φορές στο Ρήσιο και το είπε και ο ίδιος ότι το έκανε μαζί με τον Νέτο. Πρέπει να τα δίνεις όλα. Προσπαθώ να είμαι επαγγελματίας και να τα δίνω όλα ώστε να είμαι καλύτερος στον αντιπαλό μου. Η Θεσσαλονίκη είναι μια ωραία πόλη που μπορείς να κάνεις πολλά πράγματα, αλλά πρέπει να ξέρεις τη στιγμή που θα βγεις και δεν θα βγεις. Είναι και σεβασμός στον ίδιο στον εαυτό και στον κόσμο και προσπαθώ να δείχνω μια καλή εικόνα προς τα έξω.
Except Neto, who other players are your friends? Giannakakis, I think he looks like Portuguese, not so Greek.
Some people they say that we look, it's true, some people they say that we look. No, you know, I have some friends, yes, I have some friends in team. And okay, I enjoy some time with the most of the person is Neto, you know, every time I meet Neto because the language, you know. But I have also other friends in the team. And okay, you know, in football team, I believe, okay, we need to be together, but in pitch is the most important, you know, not mm-hmm. outside. If my friend helped me inside of the pitch, it's very important for me. Outside, okay, we can make company, but for me, it's not the most important, it's easy, you understand?
Mm-hmm. Το ρωτήσαμε γενικότερα για τις φιλίες του στην ομάδα. Εντάξει, βασικά περισσότερη παρέα κάνει με τον Νέτο, έχει και άλλους βέβαια φίλους μέσα στην ομάδα. Το σημαντικό όμως είπε να είμαστε κοντά μέσα στο γήπεδο. Έξω μπορούμε να βγούμε και να βρεθούμε, αλλά το σημαντικό είναι μέσα στο γήπεδο να είμαστε κοντά. Mm-hmm. Θα κάνουμε διάλειμμα, Χρυσανθέμη μου?
Όχι, θα το πάμε μέχρι τις 6.30 Χριστό και θα κάνουμε σε 6.30 ένα τελευταίο διάλειμμα να πάρουμε κάποιες ανάσες. What about the game with Boca? You didn't leave the first game. The first game were 23,000. You see, this is a picture of the first game, 2009. I think it's one of the best moments. Huh?
I show the video from first game, you know. Mm-hmm. Like, I show a lot of videos from Aris. I know what is Aris, I see everything. And this game in November, I think it was November, right?
November, yes.
They show me the Aris. Mm-hmm. It was a great atmosphere, the fans are crazy. The fans support all the team, you know. This is Aris. And of course, if you ask me, I want to see every game Carilau like this, because this is Aris, my friend. It's the fans, they have the power of the team, you know. Mm-hmm.
Τον ρωτήσαμε για το μάτς με την Boca τον περασμένο Νοέμβριο. Είπε ότι είδα και το βίντεο από το πρώτο μας που έγινε το 9. Τον περασμένο Νοέμβριο ζήσε μια φοβερή ατμόσφαιρα. Αυτό είναι ο Άρης, αυτό που είδαμε. Έτσι θέλω να είναι το Χαριλάου του χρόνου σε κάθε παιχνίδι και μακάρι ο κόσμος να το πετύχει.
Mm-hmm. Probably Άρης will play match. Many games like that, but 25 of July we'll play against AEK. AEK got the championship, and I think it's a very, very good friendly game for us to see the new team and for you to test the power of the club.
Yes, you know, but it's still a friendly game, you know. Okay,
it's early.
It's early for me. It's early. No, okay, we're gonna work 20 days, 22 days with mm-hmm. new coach. It's very early to show something, you know, but okay, it's a start. We need to make our job, to show ourselves to the fans, and okay, I believe that will be a very nice game for atmosphere, because I know what these fans they can do. Mm-hmm.
Το ρωτήσαμε για το φιλικό με την ΑΕΚ που θα γίνει στις 25 του Ιούλη. Αυτό που είπε ότι είναι ένα φιλικό, είναι αρκετά νωρίς αυτό το παιχνίδι για να δείξουμε κάτι. Θα είναι πάντως ένα ωραίο μάτς από πλευράς ατμόσφαιρας που θα δημιουργήσει ο κόσμος σε εκείνο το μάτς. Mm-hmm.
Do you watch the Greek football, except the second division? Okay, you didn't watch match games. I think that now you are going, but I want to ask you something else. In Thessaloniki, I think you understand that it's difficult for an Aris fan to see a player of Aris to eat with a player of PAOK. It's the same thing for the fans of PAOK to see Matos have a friend like Sosa. It was the first time that nobody said nothing. And they say, okay, he's professional. Matos is professional. They are good for their collapse. So, okay, they can be together.
Okay, look, I know the
same thing. I believe, I don't know. Look, probably is when Benfica player, yeah. Porto player.
I know what is Aris PAOK. I know mm-hmm. because from the first day everybody say.
Yeah, okay. Don't say that. We'll say it in Michelidis.
Everybody okay? ask me to yeah. this, you know. So I understand very good the reality between Aris and PAOK, and you know I'm Aris 100%, and I will make everything to take 3 points from PAOK. Mm-hmm. So if I need to kill Leo, I will kill Leo. we are good friends. I like his personality because he's very professional. We have a similar personality.
Yeah. That's
and I have the respect of him, you know. But inside of the pitch, I don't look friends. I don't care if he's my friend or no. I will give everything. If he's Leo, if he's another player, I don't
he
care.
He uses his elbows.
Okay, I will lose too. No problem, no. So, okay, it is true. I know that, okay, some people, they speak to me. They don't speak well. Mm-hmm. But they say, so the next year, I know, not be together at PAOK. But same time, they respect me, you know, too much from Aris. And Leo also, I know that.
You earned that.
Everybody respect mm-hmm. also Leo in PAOK because we are professional, you know. We give everything for our team.
I think that fans of PAOK respect you, and fans of Aris respect Leo too. because you are good players. And anything that happens, the fan know, okay, he's a good player. I respect, when he comes, he will hear what he must hear, but the respect is the respect.
I saw that. I saw that from even from PAOK. They say some things positive about me. Mm-hmm. Okay, it's nice, but you know, for me the important is not PAOK. For me, important is only Aris.
Yeah.
If the people in my team, they like me, I don't care about other team. Okay, they can good. Say good things about me. It's nice to hear. But if they say bad things about me, I don't care. I want only to hear about people from Aris, because it's my team. I play for Aris, I don't play for PAOK.
Mm-hmm.
So for me, the important is that I give everything for Aris and they like what I make for Aris.
Τον ρωτήσαμε για το γεγονός ότι όσο βρίσκεται στη Θεσσαλονίκη κάνει παρέα με ένα παίχτη του ΠΑΟΚ, το λέω μάτς, εντάξει, τον γνωρίζουμε όλοι και είναι φίλοι.
Και είναι από τις περιπτώσεις αυτό που...
Και μαζί με τον Νέτο κιόλας να προσθέσω
ναι.
εγώ.
Είναι από τις περιπτώσεις όμως που δεν σχολιάστηκε αρνητικά.
Δεν σχολιάστηκε.
Ίσα ίσα ναι. σχολιάστηκε ότι οκ. Okay, γιατί και οι δύο είναι πολύ καλοί επαγγελματίες. Και ο Ούγκο και ο Μάτος.
Δεν είναι μόνοι. Καλοί επαγγελματίες. Πολλοί κάνουν παρέα παίξη του Άρη με παίξη του ΠΑΟΚ. Ο Ούγκο μας είπε ότι ξέρω τι σημαίνει το Άρης ΠΑΟΚ την πρώτη στιγμή που ήρθα. Εγώ είμαι Άρης και θα δώσω το 100% για να πάρουμε τους 3 βαθμούς κόντρα στον ΠΑΟΚ. Και αν χρειαστεί, χαριτολογώντας, είπε να σκοτώσω το Μάτος μες στο γήπεδο, θα το σκοτώσω.
Ναι.
Είμαστε φίλοι, τον σέβομαι, αλλά μέσα στο γήπεδο. Δεν θα είμαστε φίλοι, θα είμαστε αντίπολοι. Γενικότερα και οι οπαδοί του ΠΑΟΚ σέβονται μένα και οι οπαδοί του Άρη σέβονται τον Λέο, αλλά περισσότερο για μένα σημασία έχει να με σέβονται οι οπαδοί του Άρη, γιατί στον Άρη παίζουν.
Ωραία, θα πάμε τώρα στο διάλειμμα. Ναι. Χριστό, πάμε τώρα στο break για να επιστρέψουμε, να πάρουμε μια ανάσα και να επιστρέψουμε για την τελική ευθεία των τοποθετήσεων του Ούγκο Σόζα εδώ live από το στούντιο του Λίμπερο 107,4.
Εδώ είμαστε, επιστρέψαμε Λίμπερο 107,4, All About Aris On Air. Με εκλεκτό καλεσμένο τον Ούγκο Σόζα.
Learn Ούγκο to hear Greek. Yes. Know this kind of music. Μουζούκια.
Any predictions for...
Αργυρός.
Λέκα αργυρός. Ξημερώματα.
Δίνεις δικαίωμα. The best music is
Greek. I like Greek music, but I don't understand, but I like the rhythm.
You will understand.
Go with the rhythm. Because he understands the English songs, no.
Why?
And you dance, huh?
Understand.
You understand?
Yeah, all of them.
Okay. Is there,
France, Peru.
Any predictions
about this?
What predictions? France.
Peru. You never know.
You never know. World Cup is strange. You see Brazil, Argentina, they was favorite. You know, they disappoint too much, you know. World Cup every time is difficult. Too.
Which team impressed you the most so far?
Portugal.
except Portugal.
To be honest, the best team for me is Brazil. They have the best, for me, sure is Brazil the best team.
Mexico?
No.
Against Germany,
no.
They were very good.
I have another opinion. I think that the best team to change it, the most attacking team is Belgium.
Belgium, huh? But Belgium never get nothing. You know, they have amazing players, but you see what they do. They never make something
because
special.
Because they don't have the mentality.
The mentality. Yeah.
Although they have good players, very good players that play in big clubs.
I agree. Yes.
When they go to one team, why? They have the best players that played in England. Mm. For me, England is the best.
The best, yes.
But when they go to this kind of games, they don't do anything.
This I say to you, that's why, yes.
And I don't know if England...
England is the best, but their national team doesn't go that well.
Because they don't have two good players. Who is the goalkeeper of England?
Yeah.
Everybody
Pickford.
Knows. Pickford, okay, you are a journalist. Everybody knows the goalkeeper of Portugal, the goalkeeper of Brazil, the goalkeeper of Argentina, the goalkeeper from Costa Rica.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't know who is the goalkeeper of England. That's why England can't do anything. Okay, I'm England in the World Cup, but...
The fact that they play so many games during the year...
You see, look, Portugal win the Euro... The Portugal win the Euro. Nobody expect Portugal win, you know, because we play like small
team. We weren't there, that's why.
And we play like small team and we get the Euro, you know. It was amazing. We have 11 players all together. They fight together. They stay defensive. They wait the right moment to attack.
You were a bit lucky.
And okay, we are lucky, but this is football.
Except the jokes that it's the same thing that Greece did.
Yes, I agree. the coach is the same. Maybe that's why.
Yeah, he learned. Fernando learned from Thessaloniki.
You know, we had Danilo a few years.
You know that?
I know. I play against Danilo in Porto because I play in Porto. Danilo play in Benfica. Mm-hmm. Now we play in Porto.
Some were saying back then that he wasn't good enough for Aris.
But you know, this is football. You know, we know football. Everybody that understands football, you know, sometimes is football. You say this player is not enough for this team, and after this same player, he's gonna go in the better team than he don't play in this team. You understand?
Του είπαμε για τον Ντανίλο, είπε ότι έχουμε παίξει για αντίπαλο κτλ. Αλλά αυτό είναι το ποδόσφαιρο. Κάποια στιγμή λες ότι αυτός ο παίκτης δεν κάνει, δεν μπορεί να παίξει και παρόλα αυτά φτάνει στο υψηλότερο σημείο. The day that Aris said that Danilo Pereira is coming, he was okay, 19 years old. The Greek newspapers wrote, somebody called Danilo is coming to Aris. Okay, now he costs 40 million euros. Okay.
And he was one. Okay, now he got injury because I follow too much Portugal Championship, mm-hmm. and he is one of the, to be honest, maybe the best midfield in the Portugal. You know,
so. Paco Herrera wants a midfielder. I will call Teo maybe to tell him. Maybe Danilo can buy Aris. Okay. Λέμε για τον Ντανίλο Περέιρα, τώρα είναι τραυματίας όπως είπε και ο Ούγκο. Πλάκα κάνουμε. Ψάχνουμε αμυντικό χαφ. Θα ήταν ιδανικός για τον Άρη, αλλά μάλλον θα ήταν πιο ιδανικός για να αγοράσει τον Άρη. Οπότε να πάρουμε τον Θόδωρο Καρυπίδη, μήπως γίνει καμιά προσφορά από τον Ντανίλο Περέιρα.
Let's go back to Aris. Talk us about Θόδωρος Καρυπίδης. Your relationship, your cooperation. All this time.
No, no. I need to.
How do you see him as a person, as a president?
As a player. Yeah. He believes that he was a good player. You know. He tells me if I was okay, I will score many goals and okay, I think that he presses the ball and falls down. I don't know.
About player, I don't know if he's a good player or no.
We can say whatever we like. We understand.
About present, you know, okay, I need to respect the present because he gave me the opportunity to come in Aris. He gave me, you know, the target to play in Aris. So whatever happened between me and the present, I always have this in my mind because present opened the door from Aris, you know. So mm-hmm. I need to respect him. And okay, present is a young present. He have a lot of ambition. He have a lot of target in his life. And okay, we are together now. I signed 2 years contract, and I will make everything to help him. To great things will come for him and for Harris.
Τον σέβομαι. Μου έδωσε την ευκαιρία να αγωνιστώ στον Άρη. Μου άνοιξε την πόρτα της ομάδας. Είναι ένας νέος πρόεδρος με φιλοδοξίες και στόχους και θα κάνω τα πάντα προκειμένου να τον δικαιώσω και να βοηθήσω φυσικά και τον ίδιο αλλά και τον Άρη.
Καλά, αυτά που είπα εγώ ότι πατάει την μπάλα και τα λοιπά, εντάξει, πλάκα κάνουμε. France scores goal against Peru. Άρης used to have two very good players from Peru about 20 years ago. El Camión and Chávez. But Nikos was not born yet.
Ugo wasn't born either.
Lucky goal, eh?
Yes.
Lucky goal.
It's football, you know. This is football. It's football. Mm-hmm. Sometimes the ball touch in defense and go out. Sometimes the ball touch in defense and go inside. That's why he's love football, you know. His passion. We never know what happened, you know. Mm-hmm.
This kind of goal was in Ofi, I think. It's the second goal in Ofi.
This game, you know, to be honest, if you want to speak about this, mm-hmm. I was a little sad. I cannot say that I'm 100 happy because I have target to go Super League and I believe that we are the best team in the Football League. Mm-hmm. And I have one target more personal because not from the team, personal. I want to be in the first place in the Football League mm-hmm. because if you are in first place, we're going to get one title. Okay, and this was we play in Ofi. We know that if you win Ofi, we're gonna be first. And okay, this game, okay, I think we are much better than Ofi. Ofi score one goal in first half, 2 minutes to finish, I think, the half time. And after we go to second half to press them because we know that we are better, and they scored second goal, a little lucky, you know. But this is football.
Το ρωτήσαμε για το μάτς με τον Όφη, για το οποίο για την ήττα στο Ηράκλειο, είπε ότι δεν είμαι χαρούμενος για εκείνο το παιχνίδι. Θεωρώ ότι ήμασταν η καλύτερη ομάδα στην Football League και θέλαμε την πρώτη θέση. Ξέραμε ότι αν κερδίσουμε στην έδρα του Όφη θα το καταφέρουμε. Ξέραμε ότι είμαστε καλύτεροι. Ο Όφη προηγήθηκε στο πρώτο ημίχρονο. Προσπαθήσαμε να ισοφαρίσουμε, αλλά ήρθε και το δεύτερο γκολ και στη συνέχεια χάσαμε εκείνο το παιχνίδι.
We try to learn as many as possible information about Paco Herrera and the way that he plays and what he likes and what he believes about Souza or Platelas or any player that was in the last year in Aris. And one of the information that we got is that he likes to play with three players, and he said that, oh, this player, Hugo Souza, is very good to play on the right, the three players, to be the right one, because he's fast, he goes quickly on the ball, he's tough. Okay, you think that you can play in this system, it is right back or not right back? We say that it is the right back, because now with four players, okay, I know what is right back, left back, and the two stopper. You like playing there?
Look, I play before in this system, you know. Mm-hmm. Even I play right back also before in Belgium. I play some games right back. I don't have problem, to play right, left, in middle. I will make my best for Aris for win the game. And whenever a coach option to put me, I will respect the coach and I will give my best. I know that I'm a good player. If I give everything,
I think it's difficult. Three in the back. It's my opinion.
Okay.
I don't know.
You know, every coach have his tactic. You know, I don't know. I don't speak it to coach. Mm-hmm. But if coach want to play like this, I just will give my best for the coach, for Laris. You know, So I don't have problem if I play right. Really, I don't have whatever coach decide.
But you played before.
I play before, yes. Mm-hmm. And whatever coach decide, I will respect that. And I will give my best like always.
Το ρωτήσαμε για το ενδεχόμενο να αγωνιστεί και ως δεξιός back στον Άρη του Πάκο Ερέρα. Είπε ότι έχω παίξει
σε σύστημα με τρεις πίσω.
Σε σύστημα με τρεις πίσω, ναι. Βέβαια, κυρίως με τέσσερις χρησιμοποιεί βάση το στατιστικό Ερέρα, αλλά το έχει χρησιμοποιήσει.
Ναι, έχει παίξει το 3-5-2. Ναι, όχι, εγώ είπα ότι μία από τις πληροφορίες που μάθαμε, γιατί δεν μεταφράσαμε και την ερώτηση, ήταν ότι όταν σε ένα σύστημα 3-5-2, ας πούμε, ότι του αρέσει μερικές φορές να παίζει αυτό το σύστημα και είπε ότι ο Ούγκο ταιριάζει σε αυτό το 3-5-2 να παίζει, να είναι ο δεξιός παίκτης στο σύστημα.
Είπε ότι έχω παίξει σε αυτή τη θέση κάποιες φορές στο Βέλγιο. Δεν είναι πρόβλημα για μένα. Εγώ θα κάνω το καλύτερο για τον Άρη. Όπου με βάλει ο προπονητής, θα σεβαστώ την επιλογή του και θα τα δώσω όλα. Which thing is the best? You think is the best in your game and which thing you want to improve?
Nothing. He is the best one.
Of course, I don't think. I think I'm a good player. I know what I can do good. This is my point, strong. You know, like player, you need to know what you are good and what you are not so good.
Of course.
Because I'm a simple player, I know what I need to do in the pitch. You understand me?
Mm-hmm.
Of course, I need to improve some things because I'm not Sergio Ramos yet. Maybe one day I will be like him. I need to train him more. You know. So I make every day to improve, to be better in some points, and okay, this is the point. Work every day to be better player, you know.
Το ρωτήσαμε ποιο είναι το πιο δυνατό του στοιχείο στο παιχνίδι του και ποιο θέλει να πιστεύει ότι πρέπει να βελτιώσει. Είπε ότι είμαι ένας απλός παίκτης, προσπαθώ να κάνω απλά τα πράγματα μέσα στο γήπεδο. Σίγουρα πρέπει να βελτιώσω κάποια πράγματα. Δεν είμαι, λέει, ακόμα ο Σέρχιο Ράμος. Και θα το καταφέρω αυτό μέσα από τη δουλειά.
Do you have a player that an old player that you speak and you ask for his opinion? In Aris, the best stopper in the last 15-20 years, everybody said is a friend of Neto,
he's
Ronaldo Gyarro.
My friend. Too.
Ah, it's your friend too.
Yes,
too.
We meet.
Every fan of Aris says, okay, we want a Ronaldo Gyarro next to Souza. Because when he came, about 10 years ago when he came, Aris had a young player called Avram Papadopoulos played with Ronaldo and next was transferred to Olympiakos, went to Orbit. The national team, was one of the best Greek
went
players.
To Turkey, then.
Okay.
I heard all about that, my friend. I'm a part about Aris, my friend. Believe me, I know a lot of things in Aris. I know that everybody loves Ronaldo Gyarro. I saw also some videos. I spoke to him because I like to hear people more older that they have more experience. I try to learn because, like I say, I'm not the best player in the world. So I believe that every day we can improve. And we speak about some things. Ronaldo see my game also against, I don't remember the team.
He was here.
Yes, he saw one game and we speak about some things. And what I understand is different style of me, you know. I think I'm more aggressivity. Ronaldo is more calm, you know. He's more, I think, more it head. He's more,
yes,
you know, he's a different player than me. But it's true that everybody, okay, they love also Ronaldo Guiado.
Played in Benfica, I think.
Yeah, he played Benfica and Besiktas. We speak about that. He told me what he think about some position. He tried to help me, and okay, it was good to meet him. Good person, good character. And okay, I try to follow also what he said to me, you know. Mm-hmm.
Θα ρωτήσουμε για τον Ρονάλντο Γκιάρο, με τον οποίο μάλιστα μας είπε ότι γνωρίστηκε κιόλας όταν βρισκόταν στην Ελλάδα μέσω του Νέτο. Ξέρω πολλά λέει γενικότερα για τον Άρη, γνωρίζω ότι ο κόσμος λάτρευε τον Γκιάρο, μίλησα μαζί του, είδε και ένα παιχνίδι μου όταν ήταν εδώ πέρα και μου είπε κάποια πράγματα. Εντάξει, είμαστε λίγο διαφορετικοί παίχτες, εγώ παίζω με περισσότερη ένταση, αυτός ήταν πιο ήρεμος σαν ποδοσφαιριστής. Προσπάθησε να μου εξηγήσει κάποια πράγματα. Γενικότερα λέει ένας καλός άνθρωπος και ένας καλός χαρακτήρας.
Και εμείς του είπαμε ότι πολλοί κόσμος θα ήθελε δίπλα στο Ζόζο να έρθει ένας παίκτης με την ποιότητα του Ρονάλντο Γκιάρο. Για μένα ίσως ο καλύτερος ξένος παίκτης, σίγουρα ο καλύτερος αμυντικός που έχει έρθει στον Άρη τα τελευταία χρόνια. Are there any players from Sporting Lisbon? I think they have many problems and everybody goes out. Maybe you could propose some players.
I play in Sporting.
They are a little bit expensive, but okay.
I play in Sporting. I work at Leonardo Jardim in Sporting. I work. Is the same present still? Bruno Carvalho is the person that take me from Sporting. Mm-hmm. Yes, they have some problems. The fans, they make some problem there. Some player, they finish the contract there, they put in FIFA the contract because they don't feel safe or something like this. And okay, I don't know if they can come to Aris, if they can help, they are welcome, of course, because Aris want good players, you know. Mm-hmm.
But this player, I think that he goes to Manchester City. the name is,
I think it's better to come Aris.
Rafael Conceição Leao.
I know Leao.
He's good,
striker, yes, I know him.
Yeah. We need a striker.
I will call Guardiola in order to let him come
to Aris to play.
Okay, he's a good player. Very good player. So he will go to England. Okay, no problem. I read here the journalists speak about Fernando Santos and they say that he has many good players, so we should win more easily Morocco. Fight for Fernando Santos.
I saw the game, you know. Okay, we have better team. Portugal have top players. They play the best teams in the world, you know. We have amazing national team. But it's football, you know. Okay, yeah. Sometimes the best team don't win. The important is that Portugal win, take 3 points. And we are near to go the next step, you know. Okay.
And Spain, one difficult.
Okay, you see, and Spain for me, in Brazil, Spain they are the best for me in the World Cup. Mm-hmm. But it's football, my friend. Football is like this.
It's. What would you expect from Mungu in the next season? What I know, you are professional. I know that you are going to give everything. This is what we saw in the Football League. What you expect from yourself?
Look, to be honest, I stay in Aris because I want to show myself in Super League, and not to stay in Aris. I want to play in Aris. To Aris help me to give the next step, you know, because if I give next step, it's good for me and for Aris. So I will work hard to play hard to get the next step, because I know that if I give the next step, will be very good for me personal. And even for Aris will be very good. So I expect make a good season, individual, and also collective, that we make a great season to come the next step, that I believe that is possible.
Mm-hmm. Translate, Νίκο, για να πω κάτι.
Λοιπόν, τον ρωτήσαμε για το τι περιμένει, τι θέλει ο ίδιος από τον εαυτό του την νέα σεζόν. Είπε ότι έμεινα γιατί ήθελα να είμαι με τον Άρη στην Super League, θα δουλέψω σκληρά ώστε να, μέσω του Άρη, να καταφέρω να κάνω κάποια στιγμή το επόμενο βήμα στην καριέρα μου και φυσικά να ωφεληθεί και η ομάδα από αυτό. Εύχομαι να έχω μια καλή χρονιά και να τα πάω καλά με την ομάδα.
This is something that all the fans must understand, that the player plays for the club
and for his contract. And because the fans think that, okay, Ugo came to Aris. He's 23, 24, 25 years old. Okay, until 37 years old, he will play for Aris. This is not something that happens. Okay, maybe sometimes will happen. If the money are okay, if the environment is okay, but everybody must understand that the players now in 2018, they come to a club and maybe will go to another club.
Yes, of course, I'm agree to 100%, you know, but like we speak before, in this moment, personality, I'm very happy to stay in Aris. Why I'm happy? Because it's very nice to play one team that the people, they love you, you understand? Mm-hmm. They respect you, your job. And it's very good feeling for one player. And okay, if I can stay in Aris more 10 years, if it's good for me, for my family, for Aris, of course I want to stay. Because if they still to respect me, if they still to love me, mm-hmm. I feel like home. You understand?
Yeah.
But football also, you know, like we speak before, is a short career. Whatever happen, if maybe in December or next summer I move, I will take Aris in my heart, you know, because what I pass in Aris is special. I'm not just one more player that come to Aris. Mm-hmm. I pass very difficult moments in Aris. I pass very difficult, believe me, for in the, my life private and career, very difficult. And now, okay, I want to give next step because I will pass great things together, all together like families, you know. Mm-hmm. So it's this important. Point. It's very important.
Είπε ότι επέλεξα στον Άρη, επέλεξα μέσα στον Άρη γιατί είμαι χαρούμενος εδώ, με αγαπούν και με σέβονται. Αν είναι καλό για μένα να μείνω 10 χρόνια στην ομάδα θα μείνω και για την οικογένειά μου. Το ποδόσφαιρο δεν κρατάει για πάντα. Ό,τι και να γίνει στο μέλλον, εγώ τον Άρη τον έχω πάντα στην καρδιά μου. Πέρασα δύσκολες στιγμές εδώ πέρα και τώρα περιμένουμε για να ζήσουμε τα καλύτερα τα οποία.
Και είπε ότι είτε υπάρχει μια μεταγραφή το Γενάρη, είτε το καλοκαίρι, είτε όταν τελειώσει το συμβόλαιό μου ή οτιδήποτε άλλο, πάντα θα έχω τον Άρη στην καρδιά μου. Και αυτό το λέω και εγώ, πρέπει να καταλάβει και ο κόσμος. Το λέω και στα ελληνικά, να καταλάβει ο κόσμος ότι ο επαγγελματίας ποδοσφαιριστής είναι αυτό, παιδιά, είναι η δουλειά του. Εφόσον έχει τις προϋποθέσεις, μένει σε μια ομάδα και κάποια στιγμή που θα πρέπει να καταλάβουμε και στον Άρη, αυτό δεν έχει να κάνει με τον Ούγκο, ότι θα πρέπει κάποιες φορές, γιατί ήταν λάθος του παρελθόντος, θα πρέπει κάποιοι καλοί ποδοσφαιριστές να δίνονται και με μεταγραφή. Το σύγχρονο ποδόσφαιρο το απαιτεί αυτό. Να υπάρχει ένας μηχανισμός που να μπορείς να πουλήσεις ένα ποδοσφαιριστή και να φέρεις έναν επόμενο ποδοσφαιριστή που αύριο μεθαύριο θα γίνει το ίδιο. Πλέον πρέπει να το κάνουμε και στον Άρη αυτό κάποια στιγμή. Το κάνουν όλες οι ομάδες, όλες οι μεγάλες ομάδες.
Εδώ πουλάνε ομάδες τώρα παγκοσμίου εμβέλειας ποδοσφαιριστές.
Το κάνουν όλες οι μεγάλες ομάδες.
Να μην πουλάει ο Άρης.
Δεν γίνεται. Η εποχή Ποντίνος Κούης ήταν συμπλήρωσε 12 ετία για να μπορεί να φύγει ή όχι οτιδήποτε άλλο. Έχει περάσει. Θα πρέπει αυτό να το καταλάβουμε για να το συνειδητοποιήσουμε όλοι. Πάντα βέβαια να είναι και οι όποιες συμφωνίες συμφέρουσες για τον για το σύλλογο. Okay, we are in the end. Where you go τώρα? Πού πας?
Εγώ αύριο πάω Σαλονίκη.
Σαλονίκη.
Πορτογαλία. Πορτογαλία.
Πορτογαλία.
Yes.
Okay, your family there.
Yes, I need to see my family to take some things from Portugal.
To relax.
To relax a little with my family to be fresh when I come back.
Vacations in Greece, no, no, other
countries. You were in Crete the last days with Petros and Thomas.
Yes, I was in Kania. It was amazing. It was Kania, very nice. Yeah, beautiful beach, you know, I enjoyed there. Okay, now I go Portugal more for 6 days, 5 days, and after I will be back.
Program?
Of course, I start already to make my program. You know. We need to take care about kilos, you know. We need to be fit, you know.
You need to take care about kilos?
Okay, it's 1-2
what
kilos.
What can we say?
Ο Σόουζα λέει, παιδιά, ότι πρέπει να προσέξει για τα κιλά του.
Τι απούμε, δηλαδή.
Εντάξει. Και εμείς πρέπει να προσέξουμε για τα κιλά του, όχι τα δικά μας. Okay. Last message to the fans of Paris that hears now.
No, I want to say everybody, you know, to keep together it has will be very important that we have your support to take great things in Super League. I believe that will be possible, but we need to be together like a family, you know. This is very important step for us, and all together we're going to make Aris again big, you know. It's very important, like I say again, your support to keep together, and whatever happen, we are together.
Το δικό του μήνυμα στον κόσμο κλείνοντας, να είναι δίπλα μας, θέλουμε τη στήριξή του και πάνω απ' όλα πρέπει να είμαστε οικογένεια και να πάμε όλοι μαζί, ενωμένοι, να κάνουμε ξανά τον Άρη μεγάλο και ό,τι και αν γίνει, να παραμείνουμε ενωμένοι.
I think that Libero radio station is the best radio station that you ever came.
Yeah, I'm a pleasure to be here, believe me.
It's your first time in a radio station.
Yes, it's my first time and it's very nice. Thank you very much for
the invitation. Hope to be lucky. And we...
Αργύρος, να το.
Έτσι, μπράβο.
Don't go ξημερώματα out.
Don't go ξημερώματα.
Okay. After we have the cup, if we are the cup winners, I will take you.
Okay,
no problem.
We'll make the party.
Thank you very much. Hope the best. Hope to score goals, to prevent goals. The attackers from scoring goals. And why not be in Aris for many years? Because it will be something very good for us and for you.
And for you.
Thank you very much. You know, it's a pleasure to be here, and I will do my best for that.
Okay, let's go to Argyros now. Ναι, ευχαριστούμε πάρα πολύ που μας ακούσατε. Εμείς θα είμαστε αύριο εδώ, Νίκο. Θα
πάλι αύριο θα είμαστε εδώ.
Καλά να περάσει, Νίκο, αύριο.
Δεν θα έρθεις.
Θα έρθω.
Θα έρθεις.
Άντε, θα έρθω κι εγώ. Εντάξει. Αύριο πάλι, αύριο πάλι. All about Aris on Air στο Libero 107,4. Γεια χαρά.
Γεια σας.